In this video, I am going to design thank you card. This is very important for your business because this is a way to thank your customer for that they buy from you. So you can even offer some kind of discount or coupon to your customer to make or spread your business further. So although it's a very easy thing to do, but it's a very important part for your business or branding. So I'm going to design thank you card today. For that, first go to file, then new, and then we have to take a size of that business card. You can take any size. You can take 3 × 5 inches, you can take 5 × 5 inches, but here I'm going to take, it's totally up to you what design you want and how it should go with your branding. Okay, so here I am going to select 5 width inches and then 3.5 inches, and it should be on portrait mode. And then we have to add the bleed as well because it's for printing purpose. And then make sure that this has to be linked with all the other sizes, and then we go to advanced option and then select the CMYK mode. Why we have to select CMYK mode? Because CMYK mode is for printing purpose. But let me tell you one more thing, that is that nowadays agencies using RGB mode as well for printing purpose as well, because the color are very strong in RGB mode. But here I am going to select CMYK mode, and then we have to select the PPI. PPI basically it's a resolution of your design, then it has to be high as much as you can. And here is the largest, or you can say the biggest one is high, 300 pp, and then that's it for now. And then we have to just click create. Here is the size of our thank you card, and you can see the red line is for bleed line. Okay, and then here in this video I am going to design 2 thank you card, because so you can get an idea how you can design. So let me take here is our color palette. I am going to use this color palette in my design. And then let me decrease the size of it and put it here. Okay, then what I'm going to do is take a rectangle tool and make sure that your rectangle should go, you have to draw the rectangle to the bleed line. Okay, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to select this one, this color. Okay, you can select any color, and it has to be according to your brand identity colors. Okay, but here I am just designing individually this card, so I am taking any color. Okay, you have to make sure that your thank you card should relevant to your brand identity colors. Okay, that's it. And then I am going to take a text tool, or if you have any design or any kind of design in your mind, then you can use that. And then just write it down, thank you. Okay, and then I'm going to change the typeface, or you could say the font size or font type. Okay, here I want to select the script form, so it shows that your brand is very luxurious. And let me select this one, and let me increase the size of it first, so I can totally understand what I am going to do, what I am doing here. Okay, no, it's not good. I have to change this one. It's totally up to you what font you want to select. There is no hard and fast rule. This is your choice totally. So you can select this one as well. It looks good. So I am going to put this in the center of this. How I can do it? Just click on the align button and select the horizontal center, and then that's it. And little bit down, okay, that's it. And then you can select U in capital as well. It looks totally perfect, okay. And I want to decrease the size between this font, okay. Yeah, this looks totally perfect. And then what I'm going to do is, let me check if the line in the center or not. Yeah, this is perfect. Now I'm going to add some kind of you can say a text, that in that text you should thank you your customer that they support your business, and then you can that give them some kind of discount or token as a thanks, so they will be your regular customer to make them your regular customer, okay. And now this time the font will be very minimal and very simple, okay. Now I'm going to select the serif or sans serif font, something like this, and here I'm going to select this one, but I'm going to select the width of it. I'm going to select the regular version, or yeah, regular or medium, regular will be fine. And then I'm going to increase the size of it. This is too much. And then you can even, no, this is too much. We don't want to spread. Okay, little bit more. This is too much. Okay, now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to decrease the opacity as well, because I don't want this text to be pop up. I just want it to be here, and it should complement our design. This is, let me increase little bit more. Yeah, this one's totally perfect. And then I'm going to increase the size of it, decrease the opacity, I already did it, and then decrease the, okay, and then okay, and then little bit, this is, I don't need to touch this one. Yeah, this looks totally perfect. And then what I'm going to do is, one more thing I forgot to do is, that is, I don't want this text to be so much expanded, okay. Then I'm going to align it to the center, little bit down, and I should make sure I should little bit decrease the size again. Now again, every time whenever you make some changes in your text or design, and then you want to you have to make sure that alignment is in the center, or for that you have to do it or align the text again and again, okay. Now this looks totally perfect, but what I want to do is, I want to make sure that the text is in the center. Yeah, this looks totally perfect, but I want little bit down here. Yeah, this looks totally perfect. Now what our next step is, you can see the Facebook icon here. Now I am going to change the size of it. First let me ungroup it, and then what I'm going to do is, I'm going to little bit zoom in and put it here, and then decrease the size of it to white. I'm going to change the size of this text as well, okay. This looks totally perfect. Now I'm going to put this here and then bring it to the front. Yeah, this looks totally perfect. And then let me zoom it out little bit more, and then don't forget to group it, otherwise if you want to stretch or change the size of, change the position of this icon, it will definitely make difficulty for you, create difficulty for you if you don't group it. Okay, then after that what I'm going to do is then just write down your page name or whatever you want. Page name you we have to write it, just write it. Fashion for you. Okay, and then as I told you, I don't want this text, I'm going to change it. You can select any text, I'm going with the same one. Okay, and then just change the typeface here. This one totally perfect, but I'm going to change the size of it. Okay, nowadays everything is minimal, and so we don't need to put so many things in our design. You can see it totally perfect here, and then I'm going to change the size. That's it now. And then what our next step is, I'm going to decrease the size of it again, because I don't like this one. And how we can do it, just select this one and this one, and then I don't know if I'm doing it right or wrong, but I'm just doing it. Okay, this is totally perfect, and then put it here. Yeah, this looks totally perfect. And one more thing, I should decrease the size of it. Okay, these things take time, but I'm telling you that you will definitely like it in the end. Okay, this is the name of our page. Okay, and if you want to decrease the size more, then you can do it. And if you want to change the pop-up, or if you want to do it to bold, you can do it. Now this looks totally perfect. And then what our next step is, you can see it how beautiful it is. And then the next step is you have to put your logo here. I don't have any logo right now, so just I'm going to write it down the text here. Simple text, you just what you have to do, you just need to write down your, okay, make sure you don't use too many fonts or too many typeface, otherwise it will definitely look messy, or you and your client will definitely not like it. And this look totally perfect. Let me bring it little bit more, and then align it to the center and make sure little bit down, we have to down. You can see it how beautiful it is. You can even do one more thing, just give a little bit design, and that's it, decrease it, and then you can, it looks totally perfect. Then just give the line to white color. Let me decrease the, just increase 1 point. You don't need to add. Let me check if this one is okay or not. Yeah, this looks totally perfect. And then take a copy of this design by pressing Alt and just put it here. Or you can even decrease the direction as well, like this one. And then reflected, I think. Increase the size little bit more, and this looks totally perfect and elegant, you could say. Little bit more, decrease it, and that's it. You can see it, it looks totally perfect and yet elegant. And you can see it, just we did add just little bit, add text and icon and text font. And this is our first thank you card. Now let me save this one, and then we will move to the second one. Okay, and then let me delete this one first, and then I'm going to save it. Thank you card. And just export it. and then we are done here. Now let's move to the second one. Now we have to do the same step, go to file new, and then you can see it 5 inches width and 3.5 height, and then 0.125 bleed. Advanced mode, we have to check it one more time, and CM bike mode for printing purpose, and then high 300 PPI means 300 resolution, and then create it. That's it. And then what I'm going to do is, I have already something in my mind, then I am going to design according to that that, and then take a rectangle tool, as I told you, draw it from the bleed line, and then try that your design should not something like that which cut your bleed line, okay. And then what I'm going to do is, I'm going to select the color of this. Here is our color this time, and then I want it little bit darker, like this one, and this look little bit light. This is too dark. Yeah, this one totally perfect. And then what I'm going to do is select this one, and then control plus two to lock this layer. So whatever we do, we will not face any difficulty. Then what our next step is, I'm going to take a LS tool, and then first I'm going to design something like that, some design here, and then after that we will do we will add some text, okay. And then let me change the size of it. Here is our design. It's quite easy and simple, but yet elegant, okay. You can use any design, is totally up to you. There is no hard and fast rule, okay. Let me take a see this, what will it looks like. Okay, as I told you, I know little bit this one will be little bit bigger than the usual. Let me see it again. Yeah, this one looks perfect, little bit more, okay. And then take a copy of it, and then again change the color of it. Put it here, okay. And then again take a copy of it. This time I am going to select the white one, okay. This one totally perfect. And then when I am going here, come here, and then decrease the size of it, because we don't want the bigger one in the middle of this, okay. And then this one put it here, there. You can, I think, understand what I'm going to do here, what I'm doing here, okay. There, put it here, and this one here, this one here. Don't worry, this one when it, because there is a bleed line in the red one, that's why I take the big circle here, okay. I think you guys understand how to design in the bleed line, okay. I will show you one more time the final result, what we will get in the printing, so don't worry. And then let me decrease the size of it again. And then I think I should change the color of it, okay. This one, okay. And then again this one, and this one again the white color, okay. And then again white color. Again black color, white color. It's totally up to you, it's quite easy to do it, anyone can do it, if I can do it. That's the thing I always say to others. Okay. Okay. In this one, I'm going to select this font. Okay, now let me increase the size of it, and then again, but I don't want this font. I already used this one in the other one. This time I'm going to select the different one. Let me check it. No. Yeah, this look totally perfect. Now I'm going to select the bold one, semi bold. We will decide it later, but I want it in a italic. There is no italic in this one, so I'm going to change the font straight away. Let me do it. One more thing. Where is our font? Okay, but it has to be an italic font. Okay. Put it here. And then we have to adjust the size and the tracking, whatever you say. And then put it into the center one. Okay. Okay, then we have to set the alignment, put it into the center, and this looks totally perfect, but we have to little bit adjust it. Okay, and then make sure the Y is also in capital. Okay, and then change the Y into capital. This one looks be perfect, but you can see it, it's touching to the H1. Then we have to make some space here. Okay, this one is fine, and move, make sure it's in the center again. Okay, now we have to do the rest of our work. Now put it here. Now we understand where we have to put our design. Okay, this one. Okay, white one here, black one there, here and there. Okay, and then put it something here, this, and you can see it looks very amazing. Okay, and I think there is so many design here, so we have to adjust and take it from here. Okay, and put it here, make some space here and there. Put it here. Yeah, it's almost ready. We are almost done here, you can see it. Put it here.
let me show you the print version so you will realize what we have done here. Okay, let me change the size of it here. And change the color from here as well. You could change into white and then change the color of it from here as well. Now let me show you the final version of it so you can understand what we have done here. Okay, now it looks totally perfect and we are telling it. You can see it, how beautiful it is. Now you can design anything, but as I told you that it should complement your design, and it's totally, let me add one more thing here. Okay, you can even, you don't need to add any space, and then okay, this looks totally perfect. Now we are done here. Let me show you the other one as well so you will realize what we have done here. This is the first one, and this is very beautiful and minimal design, and this is the another one. And make sure whatever you design for your brand or for your client, to make sure it complements your brand identity, colors or design and typography and everything, and it totally goes to your mission or value you have searched or have in your mind. Okay, that's it. And like what I did, I take a rectangle tool and I'm adding a clipping mark, so whatever is outside the artboard will definitely remove it with the help of this clipping mark. Okay, clipping marks. And then make sure all the layers should be unlocked. How we can do it? Just control plus L and plus 2. We have to press all these buttons at a time, and then just select control plus A, and then right click it and make clipping off. This is done here. It looks totally perfect and amazing. You can design any design and make sure it has to be minimal. Thank you card is something that you don't need to add so many design or so many things on it. It has to be minimal and it should complement your brand identity. That's it for now. Hope you like this video. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel and share this video as much as you can. Bye.